Blessed are you, Lord our God, King of the universe. From the rising of the sun to its setting, your name is proclaimed in all the world. The Lord of glory be with you.
And also with you.
Good morning and a very warm welcome. Today we celebrate the Epiphany. I'm here because Deborah is not feeling 100% today, so I'm trying to stagger through this. We begin our service by saying together the prayer of preparation. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The grace of God has dawned upon the world through our Saviour Jesus Christ, who has sacrificed himself for us to purify a people as his own. Let us confess our sins. God, be gracious to us and bless us, and make your face shine upon us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May your ways be known on the earth, your saving power among the nations. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You, Lord, have made known your salvation and revealed your justice in the sight of the nations. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you. Pardon and deliver you from all your sins. Confirm and strengthen you in all goodness and keep you in life eternal. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let me stand to say the glory. Glory to God in the highest,
and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, Heavenly King, Almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Grateful for the glory revealed today through God our flesh, let us pray. O God, who by the leading of a star manifested your only Son to the peoples of the earth, mercifully grant that we, who know you now by faith, may at last behold your glory face to face. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Would you please be seated for our first reading?
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Arise, shine, for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord has risen upon you. For darkness shall cover the earth, and thick darkness the peoples. But the Lord will arise upon you, and his glory will appear over you. Nations shall come to your light, and kings to the brightness of your dawn. Lift up your eyes and look around. They all gather together. They come to you. Your sons shall come from far away, and your daughters shall be carried on their nurses' arms. Then you shall see and be radiant. Your heart shall thrill and rejoice, because the abundance of the sea shall be brought to you. The wealth of the nations shall come to you. A multitude of camels shall cover you, the young camels of Midian and Ephah, and those from Sheba shall come. They shall bring gold and frankincense, and shall proclaim the praise of the Lord. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. His star at its rising, and have come to pay him homage. When King Herod heard this, he was frightened, and all Jerusalem with him, and calling together all the chief priests and scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Messiah was to be born. They told him, in Bethlehem of Judea, for so it had been written by the prophet, and you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah. For from you shall come a ruler who is shepherd of my people Israel. Then Herod secretly called for the wise men and learned from them the exact time when the star had appeared. Then he sent them to Bethlehem, saying, go and search diligently for the child, and when you have found him,
Bring me word that I may also know and pay him homage. When they had heard the king, they set out, and there ahead of them went the star that they had seen at its rising, until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw that the star had stopped, they were overwhelmed with joy. On entering the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother, and they knelt down and paid him homage. Then, opening their treasure chest, they offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they left for their own country by another road. This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Let us pray. Eternal God, who by the shining of the star led the wise men to the worship of your Son, guide by his love the nations of the earth, that the whole world may behold your glory, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
May I speak in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Today we celebrate the Epiphany, the arrival of the wise men. The wise men, or magi, are thought to be Medes from Persia. The Medes became a tribe of priests who were almost exactly what the Levites were in Israel, a people of holiness and witness who sought for truth. That these learned men could follow a star may seem foolish to us, but we must remember that in those days, everyone had great faith in astrology. They believed that the stars foretold the future. We cannot tell what star the Magi saw, but it was their profession to watch the heavens, and some brilliance, heavenly brilliance, spoke to them of the entry of a king into the world. I think the star was God's way of speaking to them, and that they had he had a plan for them. It may seem to us extraordinary that those men should set out from the east following a star to seek a king. Yet many and varied are the ways that people are led on their journey to Christ today. There is not the slightest need to think the story of the coming of the Magi to the cradle of Christ is only a lovely legend. It is exactly the kind of thing that could easily have happened in that ancient world. When Jesus came, the world was an eagerness of expectation. He came to awaken the world. The earth, the ends of the earth, were gathered at his cradle. It was the first sign of Christ's conquest of the world. No sooner was Jesus born than we see the reaction of different groups, the same reaction found today in regard to Jesus Christ. There was the reaction of Herod, of hatred and hostility. Herod was afraid that this little child was going to interfere with his life, his place, his power, and his influence. Therefore, his first instinct was to destroy him. There are still those who would gladly destroy Jesus Christ because they see in him the one who interferes with their lives. These people wish to go their own way, and if they follow Christ, they cannot do just as they like, so they are keen to get rid of him. Christians are people who have ceased to do as they like and have dedicated their lives to follow in Christ's footsteps with his help as best they can. There was a reaction of the wise men, the reaction of adoring worship, the desire to lay at the feet of Jesus the noblest of gifts that they could bring. Surely, when we realize the love of God in Jesus Christ, we too should be lost in wonder, love, and praise. In the early days, Eastern tradition said that there were 12 wise men, but now the tradition that there were 3 is almost universal. The First Testament does not mention a figure, but the idea of 3 no doubt arose from the threefold gift that had been bought, and even from early times, people have seen a peculiar fitness in each of those gifts, which specially match some characteristic of Jesus and his work. Gold is a gift for a king. In Parthia, it was the custom that no one could approach a king without a gift. Gold, the king of metals, is the gift for man born to be a king. A king who was to reign not by force, but by love. Frankincense is the gift of a priest. It was the temple worship and at the temple sacrifice that the sweet perfume of frankincense was used. The function of the priest is to open the way to God for all. A person who builds bridges between people and God, which is what Jesus did. He opened the way to God. He made it possible for us to enter into his very presence. Myrrh was used to embalm the bodies of the dead. Jesus came into the world to live for us, and in the end, to die for us. He came to give us life and his death. These were the gifts of the wise men, and even at the cradle of Christ, they foretold that he was to be a true king, the perfect high priest, and in the end, the supreme savior. There came from the east wise men, Gentiles, and that concerns us, for we too are Gentiles. They were seeking the Christ child. We too are seeking Christ. They came to worship the Christ child, and that concerns us, for we too seek to worship. They bought gifts that were fitting, and that concerns us, so too should we. But what gifts do we bring? Not frankincense or myrrh, maybe, but we should give ourselves the abilities and gifts we have been given to work for the good of Christ and his church. Gold? Well, maybe not gold, but to carry out the work of the commands of Christ, the church has to be financed and solvent. It cannot function efficiently unless it is a body of people totally committed who give in their time, talents, and the necessary finance to it. The challenge to us all today. The wise men bought fitting gifts to the baby Jesus. What gifts are we bringing to him? Amen. Let us pray. Eternal God, who by the shining of a star led the wise men to the worship of your Son, guide by his light the nations of the earth, that the whole world may behold your glory, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
To Jesus, Lord of the Church, is in your mercy, hear us. Jesus, Lord of the Church,
in your mercy, hear us.
We pray that Christ may be seen in the life of the Church. You have called us into the family of those who are the children of God. May our love for our brothers and sisters in Christ be strengthened by your grace. Jesus, Lord of the Church,
in your mercy, hear us.
You have called us to be a temple where the Holy Spirit can dwell. Give us clean hands and pure hearts so that our lives will reflect your holiness. Jesus, Lord of the Church,
in your mercy, hear us.
You have called us to be the light of the world, so that those in darkness come to you. May our lives shine as a witness to the saving grace you have given for all. Jesus, Lord of the Church,
in your mercy, yes.
You have called us to be members of your body, so that when one suffers, all suffer together. We ask for your comfort and healing power to bring hope to those to bring hope to those in distress. Bring into you those on our prayer list, remembering Carolyn Johnson, Nona Harrison, Jim Bale, Heather Moore, Babs White, John Allen, Ali Millwood, Barbara Walton, Tony Moore, and any others who are personally known to us. Jesus, Lord of the Church,
in your mercy, hear us.
You called us to be the bride, where you, Lord, are the bridegroom. Prepare us for the wedding feast, where we will be united with you forever. Jesus, Lord of the Church,
in your mercy, hear us.
Jesus, you have called us into the fellowship of all your saints. We remember Alexander, Handley, and those in our year's mind, Mac McKean and Graham Seward. Now that they are in your loving arms, we unite our prayers with theirs and ask for your grace to serve you with joy, and where you live and reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and for all eternity. Amen.
The increase of his government and of peace, there shall be no end. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Please be seated.
Thank you.
people's gifts, not gold, frankincense, or myrrh, but hearts and voices raised in praise of Jesus Christ, our light and our salvation. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
All honor and praise be yours, always and everywhere. Mighty Creator, ever-living God, through Jesus Christ, your only Son, our Lord. For at this time, we celebrate your glory, made present in our midst in the coming of the Magi. The King of all the world was revealed to the nations. In the waters of baptism, Jesus was revealed as the Christ, the Saviour sent to redeem us. In water made wine, the new Creator was revealed at the wedding feast. Poverty was turned to riches, sorrow into joy. Therefore, with all the angels of heaven, we lift our voices to proclaim the glory of your name, and sing our joyful hymn of praise.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Lord, you are holy indeed, the source of all holiness. Grant that by the power of your Holy Spirit and according to your holy will, these gifts of bread and wine may be to us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, who, in the same night that he was betrayed, took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat, this is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, after supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." Great is the mystery of faith.
Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again.
And so, Father, calling to mind his death on the cross, his perfect sacrifice made once for the sins of the whole world, rejoicing in his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, and looking for his coming in glory, we celebrate this memorial of our redemption. As we offer you this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, we bring before you this bread and this cup, and we thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and serve you. Send the Holy Spirit on your people, and gather into one in your kingdom all who share this one bread and one cup, so that we, in the company of the Blessed Virgin Mary, Saint Michael, and all the saints, may praise and glorify you forever. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory be yours, Almighty Father, for ever and ever.
Amen.
Believing the promises of God as our Saviour taught us, so we pray.
Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
We break this bread. We break the bread of life. That life is the light of the world.
God, here among us, light in the midst of us, bring us to light and life.
Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Grant us your peace. God's holy gift for God's holy people.
Jesus Christ is holy. Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father.
The body and blood of Christ keep you in eternal life.
Amen.
Thank you. the bright splendor of all the nations, may we, who with the wise men have beheld the glory of your presence, discern the radiance of your Son, even Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We say together,
Almighty God, we thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him we offer you our souls and bodies to be a living sacrifice. Send us out in the power of your Spirit to live and work to your praise and glory. Amen.
Would you please remain in your seats until you are directed to leave? We will leave by the side door. Thank you. No more notices?
No one.
A young lady waving to me makes me feel young again. Oh no.
As some of you know, I made rather a lot of Christmas masks in aid of the Children's Society before Christmas. Two people have asked me today if I should be making everyday ones. So I think I will get my sewing machine out in the next couple of weeks, and they will be at the same price of £2 each, should you want one. Thank you. I'll make you one.
Thank you. Right, this one. This is one of Carol's. I was just smiling to myself. Nothing to do with the service, but I guess there are some people around who say, it'd be difficult to find three wise men these days. There we come to the blessing. Please stand. Christ our Lord, to whom kings bow down in worship and offer gifts, reveal to you his glory and pour upon you the riches of his grace. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you and remain with you always.
Amen.
We have seen his glory, the glory revealed.